Hi everybody, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is Beauty by Nisi. If this is your very first time, you're most definitely welcome. So as you can tell, we are looking very fall today. So today's video is gonna be a fall makeup tutorial. I had so much fun filming this look, so I would advise that you watch this video all the way to the end.
Alright guys, so to start off, I worked on my eyebrows. I made sure that my eyebrows were done. The steps are the same. And then I clean it up with my LA Girl Pro Concealer.
I'm going to prime my eyelids with the Urban Decay eyeshadow primer portion. This is the anti-aging one. And I just started using this product and I am really in love with it. It is so good. It makes my eyeshadow a lot brighter. So if you wanna see all the pigments, like most of the pigments, and you want your eyeshadow, especially when you use different colors, if you want it to show, I would advise that you invest in this primer. It's not the cheapest, but it's really good. I like it. I really do. I'm gonna blend the eyeshadow with this Real Techniques brush. I'm gonna go in this HudaBeauty Warm Brown Obsessions palette. You guys have seen me use this palette before in several videos. I'm gonna go in this palette and then I'm gonna look for this palette actually does not have any names on it, and you can tell that I've already hit pan. I'm gonna go into this brick red shade as my transition color. So guys, I really wanted to tell you about this palette. I think this palette retails for $20, but this is better than the other palette that I reviewed in my previous video. That reminds me, if you've not seen my video, you need to see it. It is the Natasha Denona Lila palette. I will leave a card here or I'll leave it in my description. But this palette is actually good. I love it. If you can tell, I have even hit pan on this one and I'm almost hitting pan on this other one. If you don't want to invest in that Desert Dusk palette, this is a very good one. And I've seen that she has brought a few more of that of this kind of palette. And this palettes don't have individual names on the shadows, so I'm just gonna tell you what the colors are. So I am really thinking of what I'm really gonna do. So I'm gonna go into the Morphe and Jaclynhill Bold collection. I'm using the Bling Boss, guys, and this palette is actually a very good dupe for that Natasha Denona. This is $15 and it's a really good dupe. You can find almost all the colors in the Natasha Denona palette in this, and you can also get a lot more because this has 12 shadows and that one has only 5 or maybe 6, I don't know. Oh, I totally forgot. So I'm gonna go into this shade. It's called Mystic. I'm gonna go into that shade. It is, ooh, I almost dropped it. It is a dark purple with, I'll just call it a dark purple. Yeah. So guys, whilst I was, when I placed the product, I actually placed it in the outer corners of my eye, and then when I blended, I only blended it to just like halfway. I didn't bring it all the way in, and we just want to create this more smoky look. So if you want that look, you just don't want to bring it all the way in. You leave it here in the outer corner. So I know I talked about the Mystic palette, but just to make sure that this look is more budget friendly, if you do purchase the Huda Beauty palette, the Warm Obsessions, if you use this first like I did, you can also use this shade or even that one up. If you don't want to go too dark, you can use this one. This is also a purple shade. It is not as dark as the one that I used, but if you are of a fair, a lighter complexion, you could definitely do this. And even I could still do it. I mean, it is not that light, so it does really show. Just so you guys have options, and so you don't have to buy two palettes, just one can create this look. And then for my lid, I was actually debating. I think I'm gonna do, okay, Pizzazz, I'm not sure, P-I-Z-Z-A-Z. I'm gonna do that on my lid. Okay guys, so if you follow me on Snapchat, I know about, I had to spray my brush to get more pigment. I know about probably 3 weeks or maybe a month ago, I posted on my Instagram asking if you guys have a problem when you shop online, like finding your foundation and basically shopping for makeup online, if you guys have problems. And a few of you responded, which thank you so much for responding. I really do appreciate. And I really wanted to, actually that was my video idea for that week when I was asking for those things, for the, when I was asking those questions. So I decided to actually go out and do like almost like a vlog, go out to a drugstore like Ulta, a drugstore like Walgreens or Ulta, to see if they will let me film the process of me finding a foundation on my own without any help or without any without any help. And so I went to Ulta and they flat out told me no cameras allowed whatsoever. They told me no, I couldn't do it. And anytime that I went to Walmart, because I've seen other videos where they would film, and I think most of those stores were Walmart, and sometimes they would not allow them too. So I didn't know. I'm like, well, do I ask? And if I ask, then they tell me no and they see me with a camera, I could like really get into trouble. Or do I just like don't ask and just sneak my camera in there and start filming, you know? Because I wanted this that video to be very practical, like be there, test the product, show you how, even though at the drugstores you don't they don't have testers there. I mean, Ulta does. Ulta, you can test the product. They have testers where you can test the product and then you can decide on which shade you are. They have people there who will help you all the time. So honestly, Ulta wouldn't really apply. But they had a variety of products, which was high-end and low-end. So I thought it was the best place to do it. And Sephora is just, most of it is high-end, especially the foundations. So I didn't want to go to Sephora. So I'm still thinking about going to Walmart. I don't know about Walgreens, but I was thinking about going to Walmart because my Walmart is the super center one, the one closer to my house, and it's quite busy. So I'm thinking nobody will pay attention and I could just sneak in and get it done. So I still do have that video in mind, guys. I have really not forgotten about it. It's just that I want to make sure I give you guys the best content whenever I'm putting out a video. So I'm gonna go into this shade and then I'm just gonna clean out the crease just a little bit. But when I'm doing that, I'm not gonna bring it to where I have the darker color. I'm just gonna stay in this corner. Hopefully it's not too dark. Okay, so I'm gonna stop here with the eyes. I'm gonna stop right here. I'm not gonna do anything else. I'm gonna go do my face. So I'm gonna put on my primer, my foundation, the usual stuff, highlighter, concealer, highlighter, whatever. So after I get the entire face done, and then I'll come back to the eyes. Today's primer is gonna be my Born This Way primer. So good, smells good, performs perfect, really good. So for foundation, I'm gonna go in the Covergirl True Blend Matte Foundation. I'm in the shade D50. I don't think I've ever used this foundation in any of my videos, but I do own one, and it's pretty good. I mean, I'm not wowed about it. Concealer, Born This Way. So I'm gonna brighten it up a bit with the butterscotch. It's pretty bright. And if you guys don't know, I wanted to put it out there. So I do freelance makeup on the side. So if you live in the Cincinnati, Ohio area, anywhere actually in the United States, book your girl. We do flawless makeup. I just wanted to put it out there because I think most of you guys don't know that I do that on the side. But that is like, this makeup is actually like a hobby for me. I'm trying to find my concealer and I can't find it. So as I was saying, makeup is like a hobby for me. I really enjoy watching makeup tutorials. Like anytime I am bored and I have nothing to do, I will like immediately get on YouTube and start watching videos. Like, I'm starting to contour my lips. This is my first time, so let's see how that goes. And then to set my entire face, I'm using the MAC Mineralize Skin Finish in the shade Give Me Sun. And guys, I was just thinking about, as I'm doing my makeup, a few ideas are dropping in my head. And I wanted to have a discussion about something, but I wasn't sure. So I wasn't sure if you guys were gonna be interested in what I was gonna say. So this is what I'm gonna propose. In the comment section below, I can't even talk. In the comment section below, I want you guys to leave a comment on the next time that I'm doing a makeup, a video. I need you to let me know what things that I should talk about. I'm gonna use this e.l.f. eyeshadow brush. It's actually a flat brush, but it's very thick, so I wouldn't use that as my eye lid shadow, but it works perfect under the eye. So to apply, I'm gonna do the crease shade. I'm just gonna do that, and we might do the darker shade too. I'm not sure yet. Might do the darker shade to smudge it out and to smoke it out. Guys, this eyeshadow is so pretty. I didn't know that this Morphe bolt. I know that when it came out, people were complaining that even the second batch that came out still were bad. This is the second batch, and I love all the shades. I love all the palettes. There's like four, I think there was four palettes, or maybe five, I can't remember right now, as usual. I can't remember anything at all, ever. But I really, really, really love it. So I'm gonna do the second dark purple. I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna use that to smudge it, because I don't want it to be too smoky. So for the inner tear duct, I'm gonna use Balsy. It's a gold with specks of purple and silver in it. So it's a very pretty color. I hope it shows up. I'm just gonna dab my brush, and then I'm gonna spray it. For bronzer, I'm using ColourPop bronzer. This bronzer could actually pass for a blush, because it has very pigmented red undertone. I'm gonna use that to carve out my cheeks a lot more. Highlight, I'm using the Maybelline Master Chrome highlighter. It's the shade Molten Gold. For blush, we're doing MAC Pinch Me. It's a goldie, but so I'm gonna set my entire face with this Milani Make It Last setting spray. Now, this is my first time using this setting spray, and if any one of you guys has used it, let me know how you feel about it. This is my first time, and I'm not testing it. Like I said, I'm just gonna wipe this makeup off after I'm done. So I don't know if it actually lasts. So let me know, guys. So it actually smells good. So to line my lips, I'm using MAC Current. Okay guys, so this is the final look. I hope you like it. I really do, especially the lip. I'm not too sure. I usually will do like a red lip, but today I wanted to do something different. Let me know if you guys like the lip that I used. Let me know. Yeah. But okay guys, so this is the end of the video. I really had a lot of fun filming this video, and I hope after I edited this video is not way too long, because I realized that this time around I did talk a lot. So I don't know if how long this video is gonna be, but this shows that I really enjoyed filming this look, and I hope you guys had fun as much as I did. If you did and you have not subscribed yet, I mean you've watched this video all the way to this part, I will advise that you subscribe and you join the family. And I'll also love it guys if you would share this video on your social media platforms. I really want to grow this channel, so please share this video and invite your friends, tell them about it, let them come watch this video. Hopefully we can all learn something. So give me a like, give me a thumbs up, okay, and leave me a comment, and also subscribe if you have not. All right guys, thank you so much, and I will see you in my next video.